Grande with protein, please. Profi Trend sweeps social media and even hits Costa as foodies add protein powder to their morning brew to boost weight loss and improve their workouts. Some people believe combining protein with the caffeine in your morning brew boosts weight loss and improves workouts. It does not. Protein powder is not a weight loss supplement per se, and I'm not aware of research where combining protein powder with caffeine would make it so. Jeff Side is now with MyProtein during his endless list of supplement companies that have sponsored him during his career. Catching that Malibu sunset, got my lead bar, helping me curb those sugar cravings. Well, that's a relief. What are your three favorite supplements? Trend Decaclen.
Look, I got my three favorite supplements right here.
I was close. And flavors? Do those come in flavors?
It's a wild cherry flavor.
Who cares what flavor protein Jeff Side likes? Great advice. Sometimes people are very misleading and forget the honesty and humility play a big role in our lives. This dude is the definition of misleading. Who are the people that think that this guy is the beacon of honesty and humility in the fitness industry? Scientists are using parkour squirrels to develop more agile robots. Alvin, Simon, and Theodore. Were they squirrels? Close enough. Let's not overthink it. Talking of which, I spent 24 hours in a gym. I was forced to throw an insane frat party. Legit my most entertaining video yet. Legit his most entertaining video yet. And I know that because he told me so himself. Humble. Furthermore, this party was insane. And again, I know that because he told me so himself. And that picture's on point. Perfect angles, everyone. Good work. Let me steal that from my thumbnail and just make it slightly less aesthetic. And so this guy is David Lay's best mate. They live together or something like that.
Because this fella just downs a handful of supplements because David Lay told him to.
Did you shoot all of them?
And people love him, but I think he makes stupid videos.
Crazy things happen at the Wish House. New YouTube video reveals it all. 7 models, 1 man, 1 mansion. Now, I'm not a mathematician, but...
But fine, people are allowed to love him. That's their opinion and choice. But what is not legit entertaining is selling them the worst supplement collaboration ever produced. I mean, spiders and this guy produce this, which is pretty sh**. But you, sir, have raised them by a new level of redundancy.
When all of you make the I'm quitting YouTube, this is my last video, can you please stick to your word? Instead of using it as some kind of clickbait as a catalyst for your future videos.
And so two of the worst supplements not evidence-based for purpose are, of course, branched-chain amino acids for muscle repair and growth and glutamine for recovery. I have in-depth videos on both of them, so I won't repeat myself. But in short, glutamine does not have the bioavailability to be effective as a supplement for recovery. And so here are some quotes from Robert Chinetsky. Glutamine is an incredibly cheap ingredient and a big reason it's used to fill out low-quality pre-workouts, amino acid supplements and protein powders. On top of that, supplement companies are hedging their bets that the average consumer doesn't really know all that much about supplements, and they're making millions off of the uninformed consumer. It has incredibly low bioavailability. In other words, when you consume glutamine orally, it's not taken up very well by the body. This has to do with the fact that the stomach, liver, and intestines love glutamine. They're greedy. They don't want to share glutamine. And when you consume glutamine supplements, the glutamine passes through all of those organs before it has the opportunity to enter your bloodstream and be delivered to the muscles. Essentially, those expensive glutamine supplements are gobbled up by your GI system and never really make it to your muscles. And to further drive home the point, other research indicates that supplementing with glutamine may actually harm you. And so if you want more information on that, please go and read Robert Chinetsky's articles. And this dude, in his infinite wisdom, combined the two. I f***ing love the fitness industry. And even more so that this company is called Transparent Labs. Stimulating protein synthesis.
Does it, mate?
Ooh, a reference. Which I'm pretty sure you were hoping no one was going to read. Now, of all the BCAA rat studies, this one is my favorite, my very, very favorite. Splinter excels in this one. Did Transparent Labs and Jesse seriously give a rodent study as their main research supporting this BCAA supplement, you absolute donuts? I can't think of any more celebrity rats, but if I could, I'd be listing them by now. Pinky in the Brain, are they rats? Are they mouse, mice? What's the difference? What's the difference between a mouse and a rat? One of life's mysteries. You tell me, Transparent Labs, and Jesse, how dare you call yourself James West, because you love to cite them as applicable research when selling your supplement to your consumer base. And by the way, for anyone who doesn't know, leucine, which is a BCAA, is a trigger for protein synthesis, but as an isolated supplement, it is not effective for muscle growth. It does not hack muscle growth. It does not keep you anabolic, for example. You need all 9 essential amino acids for effective muscle protein synthesis and growth, which you can achieve through food sources, or you can achieve through complete protein supplements. This is garbage. But if you don't listen to me, you can listen to people like Dr. Eddie Joe or Dr. Schoenfeld, who again spit in the face of BCAAs. Product overview. Core Series BCAA Glutamine, as with all Transparent Labs products, was created to be the best BCAA repair and recovery supplement available. The active ingredients, all backed by clinical research, let me stop you there and laugh in your face. For optimal results, consume at least 2 servings of BCAA per day. Let me stop there and laugh in your face. Take at least 2 BCAA servings a day. Oh, that's convenient, because that means I have to buy tubs and tubs of your completely useless supplement. But to be fair, that picture is legit insane. I'm sold. Accelerating fat loss through fasted training. Huh? Hold on a second. I mean, well played for giving multiple benefits to this supplement. We just cover so many aspects of the spectrum of physical fitness goals. But it's not true, is it? But 2 references. All right, go on. This will be worth it. And so, spoiler alert, neither piece of research which they cite has anything to do with the BCAA glutamine supplement and its effect on fasted training. In my opinion, they've just attached 2 pieces of research about the subject of fasted training and stuck it in their supplement marketing as somehow being applicable to their supplement. And so this study looked at fasted training on 7 men with metabolic syndrome, which is clearly your target market, isn't it, mate? And so what does this have to do with BCAA glutamine, where you state that Core Series BCAA glutamine is most effective for men and women serious about accelerating fat loss through fasted training? And I read the protocol in this study, and it has nothing to do with that supplement. It's not an intervention study with that supplement. And indeed, they even show that to you in figure 1. And you must have worse eyesight than me, because I read it like this, but you must have seen it like this. And so then the second piece of research looked at different training intensities on fat oxidation, beta oxidation, of course, which takes place in the mitochondria. I have in-depth videos on this. But this, again, has nothing to do with the supplement they are selling and fasted training. It's just looking at different intensities, how hard you are working with fasted training and that and the effect on fat oxidation. And so this is just nonsense and outright atrocious referencing. But let's be honest, most people won't read the references. And perhaps, I don't know, maybe supplement companies are hoping for that. And so to be fair to him, I haven't looked at all his supplements. I had a look at his pre-workout a bit, and it's a mixed bag for me. There's some silliness, but some very well-dosed effective ingredients also. It's not a terrible product. I mean, it does have some hilarious parts in it. Where, for example, it has this vitamin stack. How much vitamin B12 are you trying to give me? Are you sure, sir? And then they underdose certain substances such as huperzine A.
Huperzine A. And so this is a cognitive ingredient. The brain gains massively underdosed. And so in many supplements, you'll see 200 to 400 micrograms of this substance. The irony of underdosing a cognitive related ingredient is not lost on me.
And I really wanted to make that joke again. But to be fair, there are some well-dosed useful ingredients in this pre-workout. The caffeine is decent, for example. And to be fair, they do label clearly and don't use prop blends. And so seriously, well done for that. Good formulation includes L-tyrosine above the minimum effective dose. You have citrulline in there in an effective dose just, and beta-alanine if that is your cup of tea considering the jittery side effects and if you want to take it long term for the required cumulative effects. L-theanine in there, which is for some reason overdosed, where 200 milligrams is an evidence-based dose. And so when I look at this, it's not brilliant, but it's not bad. It's just in the decent for me. And so you could do a lot worse than this pre-workout if you want to choose a pre-workout. But for $55, for me, it's not high quality enough to recommend it or think that it's worth that price. But what it does show is this company and this guy can put some effective and effectively dosed ingredients in a supplement, which makes me wonder why they have to peddle this. My question to these rising fitness legends is, how stupid do you think people are when you're selling them supplements like this? Or do you genuinely not understand why this is completely redundant trash?